This is the Geneva Shore Report coming to you from the beach in downtown Lake Geneva on this sparkling, sunny, beautiful summer day. It is just divine down at the beach. You can see all the people out here, the birds flying, the boats in, some of them still out, the yachts out there circling around, just having a great time, pulling a raft, people in their tents and all different accoutrements. And here we are on...
It is Monday afternoon, July 22nd, 2019. I'm Jen Lepkowski.
Lisa Otto.
And the Geneva Shore Report. Good afternoon.
And we are here for the Monday afternoon weather and news update. So right now in the weather, we have beautiful summer weather going on. Lots of sunshine, a few clouds in the sky, but mostly a lot of great sunshine.
It is.
And we have right now
75 degrees, but humidity 46%.
Oh my gosh.
It is gorgeous.
That it's the lowest it has been in I don't even know how long.
And even the dew point is low, 53.
Yep.
It is great out here.
Beautiful summer afternoon here in Lake Geneva, and everyone's out enjoying it. Tomorrow we're going to get a little bit warmer. We're going to have a high of 77 degrees. And
tonight's a low of 54 and 53 next or tomorrow night. I mean, that's great sleeping weather.
Yeah. So we have a great couple days to look forward to. It'll warm up by the weekend, but for right now, we have the perfect summer weather. Well, at least I think it's the perfect summer weather.
I agree.
Yeah. And as far as news goes, well, we have a busy day here in Lake Geneva, and we have business over at City Hall tonight. We have a city council meeting, so a lot on the agenda, a lot up for final approvals. We have the cruise and transportation, the flying tux. They want to get their final approval for two additional vehicles so they can start earning a few bucks and providing transportation around Lake Geneva. We have Elmer's Boat Rental that is up for final approval for their lease extension, which they have been fighting really hard to get. And compared to some of the other leases over in that area with the boat rentals, they are behind. Well, their length of their lease is a lot shorter than the other one, so at least one other one. We won't name any names, but yeah, they're hoping to get final approval for an extension on their lease. And
the parking lot final approval for 40 dogs instead of the 10 that they were previously at. And that's what they were running at before, at the previous owner.
Right, they just weren't in.
They weren't following the rules.
They weren't following the rules. And the new owners, Sarah and Rachel, are trying very hard to follow the rules of the city and do everything the proper way, the legal way. So they are waiting till they get final approval to open up their services to more dog owners and dogs. So
they offer great services.
And we've stopped in there. They have, the place is looking wonderful.
It is
clean and quiet. And
we didn't hear one dog bark.
No, not one dog. In the whole 20 minutes we were there, not one dog barking until we left. And that was just because the dog was playing outside. Yeah. So it was great. I don't see any problems with that.
No.
And we have the 10-ton problem that's going to descend on Judge Sibbing in the local municipal court here, because Bob over at Bob's Beach Shack and Ruth at the Kite Store both got cited today to appear on August 27th or 22nd for $187 violations of having things outside their store. Ruth has been doing that for like 30 years, and she felt she was grandfathered in, but they said no at the city. The looming problem, however, is fair treatment under the law.
Right.
With right outside of Bob's across the street is this big banner on a city tower that basically is not advertising on site but off site, which is a violation of the same ordinance that Ruth and Bob are getting cited for. And that can't be, not under the law. You've got to have fair treatment under the law. And so our city administrator and the city are unfairly treating one business and at the expense of the others. Judge Sibbing, you got your work cut out for you, unless you recuse and send it over to Williams Bay or somewhere like that.
Well, and we were just in by Bob over at Bob's Beach Shack, and he is now in compliance. He has moved all the merchandise out of this little alcove area. Now, his is a little different than some of the other businesses, because his alcove is actually
in his own
rent on it.
Yeah, his own property.
Right. And you can clearly see it's black and white ceramic tiles compared to the city sidewalk. You can clearly see that that is part of the business and not the city. So, yeah, a lot of technical things to deal with. So we'll be following that story and we'll be sharing that with
And we'll be there on the 22nd of
yes,
August.
Yes, we will.
For sure.
And tomorrow for the special public works meeting at 6 p.m. to discuss parking. Don't know exactly what they're going to discuss yet, but it's on the agenda.
And yeah. We'll also be at the bid meeting. Yep. When they bring up the banners and try to dump this problem
That'll
onto
be a
the
good
bid,
one. Right.
Which the bid would be ridiculous if they picked up that problem.
Yeah.
All right, well, the breeze is picking up here.
Yes, it is.
And
I'm going to say it's like
eight.
I was going to say 8.8.
Okay, I'll go with you on that.
and I concur.
Okay.
All right, everyone, enjoy the rest of your Monday, and we'll be back tomorrow morning with more weather, road, and news reports. I'm Lisa Otto.
John Lepkowski.
And the Geneva Shore Report.